There are 11 days journey from Oreb by the way of Mansia unto Kadesh Barnea. Now rise up, said I, and get you over the brook Zered. And we went over the brook Zered. Verse 14. And the space in which we came from Kadesh Barnea until we were come over the brook Zered was 38 years, until all the generation of the men of war were wasted out of among the host, as the Lord swear unto them.
Father, in the name that is above every other name, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, let everyone that hears the sound of my voice be quickened by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let no child, no boy, girl, man or woman leave here the same way they came. Amen. Meet them at the point of their need. Amen. Do for them what they cannot do for themselves. Amen. Turn their lives around for good. Amen. In Jesus' name I have prayed. Amen. Let me hear an amen like thunder. Amen. Sit down. The question still is, why is it that a journey of 30 days took 38 years? Whatever it is that will prolong your journey unnecessarily, I challenge it by the authority vested in me as a servant of God. Amen. I remove it from your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
How can a 30-day journey become 38 years? Everybody say it again. Say, God forbid.
God forbid.
A journey you can do in 30 days? Now 38 years. Why? And we have been looking at the why. I began this morning talking about another reason why that journey was prolonged. Because they had no helpers. Every journey of life needs helpers. Something will be triggered in the spirit realm.
Amen.
That will create space for your helpers.
Amen.
You didn't hear what I said. I said something will be triggered in the spirit realm.
Amen.
That will create space for your helpers.
Amen.
If you believe it, let me hear an amen like thunder.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to start with a serious prayer. We're going to pray a prayer. But I will give you the background to that prayer. You see, the only thing worse than not having helpers is having false helpers. Let me repeat myself. The only thing worse than not having helpers is having people whom you think are your helpers, but actually they are working against you. I call them false helpers. You think they are working for you, but they are working against you. It is worse than not having helpers. Because if you don't have helpers, at least you know you don't have. But when you have people that look like helpers, but they are actually working against you, it is worse. You don't need them
at all.
And we are going to pray. We will dislodge them.
Amen.
Look, let me tell you. Anytime I raise a prayer point, it's intentional. It is by revelation. In the first service, I said it that I will pick this up. Because it came from my prayers at night. The Lord said, we must pray this prayer. That there are many of you here. The reason your journey is prolonged, why you keep struggling over one project, over one thing in your life, why you the things are going up, and is because there are false helpers around you. people who are not helping you but look like they are helping you. We are going to dislodge them.
Amen.
They must remove their hand from your life. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to give you a background because we're going to get into this prayer. Listen very carefully. In the life of David, Mama, David had a lot of helpers. There were lots of men that came to help him. And among them was the man called Joab. Joab, in fact, became the commander of David's army. If you are not a helper, how can you become a commander? But I want to show you some things. And as you look at them, decide for yourself whether this is really a helper. Now, but this man was the commander of the army. If you read 2 Samuel chapter 12, you read 2 Samuel chapter 12 from verse 14 to about verse 21, you will see a story of how Joab went to a certain city. Now, every army general goes to war on behalf of his master. Is that not true?
Yes, sir.
Now, Joab went into this particular city. He captured the palace. He captured some parts of the city. You know what he did? He sent a message to King David. He said, King David, if I were you, I will come here in a hurry so that you might now defeat the rest of the city and win the city. If you don't do it, I will win the whole city and give it my own name. Is this a helper?
No, sir.
Read it. I didn't make it up. It's there. 2 Samuel, I believe it's 2 Samuel chapter 12. Now, in 2 Samuel chapter 14, verse 23, did you know that it was Joab that brought Absalom back? How many of you know who Absalom was? Absalom was already on self-exile. He killed his brother and ran away. It was Joab that arranged and brought him back. Remember, Absalom was the one who sacked his father and took over the kingdom, slept with all his father's wives in public. It was Joab that brought him. I'm talking to you about somebody who is supposed to be a helper. In 2 Samuel chapter 20, verse 9, there was another army general called Amasa. Joab suspected that this man will take over from him because he looked like he was better than Joab. In fact, David sent this man on an errand. While he was on an errand, Joab set an ambush and killed him. Is this a helper?
No, sir.
In 1 Kings chapter 1 verse 7, 1 Kings chapter 1 verse 7, when Adonijah, another son of David, wanted to take over the palace from his father, do you know who he consulted?
Joab.
Joab. Read it. And the Bible says Joab helped him. The coup failed, but Joab did what? Helped him. No wonder in 1 Kings chapter 2 verse 5, David, when he was admonishing Solomon, you know what he said to Solomon? He said, you know what Joab did to me. Now, you can read the rest. But if you go to verse 6, he said, don't allow his head go to the grave in peace. In other words, don't allow Joab die a natural death. Can you see what I'm saying? So Joab looked like a helper, but he was not a helper. But you see, he was so powerful that David could not do anything to him. So what David did was to transfer it to his son and say, kill the man. If you continue to read, you will see that Joab was one of the few people that they killed inside church. Solomon said, if you like, he ran into church and stayed there for 6 months. Oh yes, he ran into the church. He stayed inside. Very smart. And Solomon said, inside church, I will come and meet you and kill you there. God will not be annoyed with me. Do you call that a helper?
Yes,
No. He looked like a helper. Stand on your feet. Stand on your feet. Who doesn't fear God will fear God after this prayer.
Amen.
All those who are pretending to be helpers, whosoever they are, wherever they are, pretending to be helpers of Word of Life, pretending to be your own helpers, you. When you are building a building, they give you advice, but they don't actually want you to build that building. Don't let me start talking. Lift your hands up. Lift your hands up. Shout it, say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
All right. Hold on a minute. How many of you are ready to pray this prayer?
Ready, sir.
How many of you think it is a serious prayer? Look, let me tell you something about false helpers. When false helpers are around you, they stop your helpers from manifesting.
So true, sir.
That is why you must deal with them. If you don't deal with them, I gave you an example. Amasa had already negotiated with the rest of Israel to come and bow to David. Do you see? But Joab killed him. You see, false helpers always tag, they know your helpers. You may not even know, but they know them. They target your helpers and discourage them. They send them away from you. They push them away. They spoil you to them. Then they come and spoil them to you, to make sure that there is no connection. I don't know if you are listening to me.
Hearing,
I don't know if you are listening to me. Are you sure you are hearing me?
Yes, sir.
That is why you must deal with false helpers. Some of you are not married because of false helpers. There are people who are deceiving you, telling you that it's okay. It will work out. But they are the very people working against you. False helpers can identify your helpers very easily. They are very smart people. And they fight it. They work against you. But when they see you, they open it for you. False helpers. Helpers. Somebody. Everybody say, in the name of Jesus. I can't hear your voice. I want you to shout it. This prayer is going to change many things in your life. Lift your hands up. Shout it again. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I can't hear your voice. Shout it again. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I spiritually identify false helpers.
Spiritually identify false.
You, Joab of my life, I arrest you by the Spirit of God. Destroy in the name of Jesus.
Destroy.
I attack you by the Spirit of God.
I attack you by the Spirit of God.
Be destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Be destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Remove your hand from my life.
Remove your hand from my
home. Remove your hand from my home.
Remove
your hand from my children.
Remove
your hand from my job.
Remove your hand from my job.
Remove your hand from my business.
Remove
your hand. Go.
Go.
Leave my education. Leave my life.
You false helper.
You false helpers.
You false helper.
You Joab of my life. I break your power. I break your power. I break your power.
I break
your
power.
Go. Open the mouth. Open the mouth and pray. 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 Pray.
By the authority that I have.
Adura. Open the mouth.
I design you. You false helpers. In the name of Jesus, I break your power from my life. In the name of Jesus, I break your power. Remove your hands from my life, from my home, from my children, from my destiny. You false helper, I destroy your power. In the name of Jesus, this is the hand of God. 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 The
him. You have been exposed.
You have been in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let me hear an amen like thunder.
Amen.
Do you believe in your prayer? Clap your hands and give God glory. If you believe in your prayer, you believe in your prayer. If you believe in your prayer, put your hands together.
Listen, let me tell you. The prayer you have just prayed has changed the direction of your life.
Amen.
You didn't hear me? Look, let me repeat. One of the reasons why some of you have never seen helpers, nobody to help you, you genuinely need helpers, but no helpers, is because there are false helpers. Where there are false helpers, you will never see genuine helpers. Genuine helpers don't mix with false helpers. They don't go together. No, they don't go together. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes,
they don't. They never go together. They never go together. Understand it. It's a fact of life. Genuine helpers and false helpers don't go together. They are two different kind of people. One group is totally wicked. Totally wicked. They are only thinking of your downfall. They don't want anything good for you. You see? So the moment they identify your genuine helpers, they push them away from you. They push them. They drive them. Some of them will go to a native doctor. They can go as far as that. Some will begin to perform witchcraft. Others will use words. Begin to speak words. Tell stories. Carry rumors about you. Things that are not true. You will not know where the story is coming from. There are some stories you hear. You wonder and say, what kind of story is this? Where is it coming from? For the next 50 years, you will never know where it's coming from. But because of the prayer of today, they are exposed, though.
Amen.
You will begin to see things that will start happening.
Amen.
God will bring them to the light.
Amen.
They will not hide. God will bring them to the light.
Amen.
Bring them to the light.
Bring them to the light.
Let the light expose their wickedness. They will no longer hide.
They will no longer hide.
False helpers. You Joabs of my life.
This is the end.
There is a new way open for this, your journey.
Amen.
You will conclude it very quickly.
Amen.
You will come and stand on this platform with your testimony.
Amen.
If you believe it, let me hear a very powerful amen.
Amen.
If you believe it, let me hear a very powerful amen.
Amen.
You will come and stand here to give your testimony.
Amen.
If you believe, you will testify. Let me hear another powerful amen.
Amen.
If you believe it, let me hear a very powerful amen.
Amen.
I said, if you believe it, let me hear a very powerful amen.
Amen.
The devil is a liar.
He's a liar.
He's a liar. He's a liar.
He's a liar.
He's a defeated
foe.
The season has changed. Ikamanondi.
Jesus.
My journey will
Jesus.
Not be long.
Amen.
It will not be prolonged.
Will be prolonged. The
enemy will not drag it on and on for nothing. Why? What is it?
What is it? Jesus.
That's not how God created
Jesus.
You. God did not create you to be pursuing one thing all your life.
At all.
Eh? Only one thing all your life. Just that one. Now only Jesus. All your life. What is it?
Jesus.
What is it?
Why?
Oh God.
My father.
It's enough.
It's enough. It's enough.
Jesus.
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 Israel wandered in the wilderness for 38 years, altogether 40, because they did not have helpers. They didn't have helpers. Look, don't let anybody deceive you. Life, in this life, every human being needs helpers.
Yes,
It doesn't matter who you are. Go and study the life of Jesus. Jesus that you and I are following. He needed help us. It will calm down now. Go. It will calm down. No more. No more. No more. Everyone needs helpers.
Yes, sir.
So, the issue of helpers began with God. Helper. 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 There are people in your life. Do you know what they tell your helpers?
No, sir.
They say it doesn't need help. It doesn't need help. Look for other people to help. No, it doesn't need help. So another human being is going to determine who needs help.
No way.
They are doing it because they don't want anybody to help you.
Yes.
Sometimes help is just in a word. Somebody just put in a word, one statement, bam. It changed everything. That is why the prayer we have just prayed now. Hear me. Right now, you are going to go wild. These false helpers, wherever they operate from, set it on fire. If it is a coven, set it on fire. If it is in a shrine, set it on fire. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If it is mouth to mouth, put fire in their mouth. Amen. Let the fire burn them.
Amen.
They will not be able to use those words again. Whatever words they have been using to spoil you, to carry rumor, put it on fire. Let fire burn them.
Amen.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Lift your hands up. Lift your hands up. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Shout it. Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
You wicked false helpers.
You wicked false helpers.
You are not helpers. But you pretend to be helpers.
Whosoever you are.
Wherever you are. Wherever you get your power from. Whatever you are doing, I set it on fire. Destroy. Destroy. By fire. Destroy. By fire. Destroy. By fire. Open the mouth and pray. You open the prayer. Pray, pray, pray.
In the book of Psalm 86 and verse 17, the Bible says, show me a token for good, that they which hate me may see it and be ashamed.
Amen.
Because the Lord has opened me and comforted me.
Amen.
Show me a token for good, that they which hate me may see it and be ashamed.
Amen.
Because thou hast opened me and comforted me.
Amen.
Lift your hands up.
Hallelujah.
I want you to receive that word. Psalm
86 verse 17.
Psalm 86 verse 17. The Lord said, I should give you that scripture. He will show you.
Amen.
A token.
Amen.
A token is evidence, something simple that we. There will be something in your life this week.
Amen.
That will be the evidence.
Amen.
That the Lord has answered your prayer. I said there will be something in your life this week.
Amen.
That will be the evidence.
Amen.
That God has answered your prayer.
Amen.
I say it again, there will be something in your life this week.
Amen.
That thing will be the evidence
Amen.
That God has answered your prayer.
Amen.
If you believe it, let me hear an amen like thunder.
We hope that you've been blessed by Pastor Ayo with his beautiful teaching and preaching during the hour of deliverance. If you have need for a special prayer, our counselors are waiting to pray with you or call any of the numbers listed. We encourage you to be a part of our church family at Word of Life Bible Church in Ward. Our ministry needs your support and prayer and your financial assistance. Your gift will be used to spread the word of God throughout our country and to the world. Please write to us at Post Office Box 2088, Warri, Nigeria.